All right, it's another edition of Comic Con Carne. You know, Free Comic Book Day is just around the corner. The issues are starting to come in to the comic shops. You need to be ready. That's May the 4th. If you want more information, you can go to freecomicbookday.com. And now, comic book news. In the wake of the attack in Boston, the Boston Comic Con was postponed. Organizers say advanced ticket holders will be able to get in on their current tickets on the new date, which is yet to be determined. We'll put a link to the event's website in the notes so you can stay informed. Just as we get a new trailer for Man of Steel, DC Comics may finally be seeing the light at the end of a very long tunnel when it comes to the rights for Superman. Federal Judge Otis Wright III has ruled that DC and Warner Brothers own the character. They own Superboy and everything else, and the deal in place with the Siegels stands firm, barring any appeal from shyster lawyers, whom many think stirred the pot to begin with. This will net the family some pretty hefty coin, and we will finally be done with the legal trouble around Superman. More DC news. Joker has a daughter. We got this image this week. It's a tease. Now, all DC says is a new threat lurks underneath Gotham City. Newsarama is speculating this could be the recently introduced New 52 version of Harper Row, who had a very convoluted backstory pre-New 52. It's still speculation at this point. Green Lantern gets a new villain named Relic. DC has released some sketch art from Billy Tan. And after all the hoopla about Jon Stewart being DC's latest target for a comic book death, he is now the lead in Green Lantern Corps, and Guy Gardner is taking center stage in Red Lanterns. Writer Charles Soule takes over the title. And right now, according to Green Lantern writer Robert Venditti, there are no plans to kill off Jon Stewart. Nobody mentioned it to him prior to his coming on board after Josh Fieldcoff walked. So for now, it's still just a rumor. Don't forget the Green Team and the Movement make their debut in May, along with the final issues of Firestorm, Deathstroke, Team 7, and Hawkman, all canceled earlier this year, and the last Green Lantern issue written by Geoff Johns. Plus, Power Girl gets her classic look back in World's Finest number 12, and Batman number 20 is shipping with four different covers. The solicitation says it's the team-up everyone's been asking for since the New 52 started, just in time for a certain movie release, maybe? Speaking of movies, just a couple of quick notes that came in after we taped Silver Screen last week. Daredevil is back with Marvel. That's official. Kevin Feige confirmed that with Newsarama during the Iron Man 3 press junket, which means what exactly for the character? How or if he shows up in the movie universe is yet to be determined, but you can be sure it's probably not going to be until Phase 3. And the 1990 Captain America movie is finally being released on Blu-ray. This is the one with Matt Salinger as Steve Rogers. Lots of names in the cast. It comes out next month. We'll try to snag a copy and do a review. And for more comic book movie news, you can zip over to the Silver Screen Edition here on YouTube. We put that out every third Thursday of the month when everything goes right. Boom Studios has announced a new project, Clive Barker's Next Testament. It's the first original comic created and written by Barker, 12 issues that will explore religious themes with art by Jaime Jiang. That's out May 29th. Red Circle has a new title in their universe to go along with the new Crusaders, The Fox. It's a new take on the pulp character, new creative team Mark Waid with art by Dean Haspiel. And Viz Media has a new manga tie-in for Tiger and Bunny. Based on the hit anime series, Volume 1 features art by Mizuki Sakakibara, and there's also a two-disc DVD set available. All that releases in May. Also next month, The Stark 7, part of the secret origin of Tony Stark storyline that begins in Iron Man 10. Note the inclusion of a certain bowler hat-wearing operative. And of course, Iron Man 3 is just around the corner. Lots of trailers and TV spots coming out there, and we'll have a review as soon as we see it. In the meantime, subscribe to our channel so you know as soon as we put a new video up. Check in with us over at Facebook, Twitter, Pinterest. check out the grid for video game news. And we've got all the latest Star Wars rumors and innuendo on Salacious Crumbs. We've got Week in Review every Saturday. More video from Planet Comic Con and Wizard World coming up, along with an interview with the Omega One webcomic team. There's something going on all the time. We can hardly keep up. So I've got to get back to work.